Hello everyone. Today I want to tell you a little bit more about our newest smart action, the Continuous Autopilot. If you haven't heard about it, we made a smart action that allows you to re-engage your autopilot when you're doing a lane change. Basically, you know when you activate your autopilot from the scroll wheel or from the stock if you're on the older models, every time you do a lane change, you need to go back and then you need to re-engage it once again through the scroll wheel or the stock. However, we made a smart decision where we can save you this extra movement by letting the car re-engage it automatically. And I'm going to show you how it works and how you should not use it when you're on the road. So what I basically have to do is first turn on my turn signal, then steer to the lane that I want to go to, and then wait a couple of seconds until my autopilot re-engages automatically. And the best option is that we made it so you can customize after how many seconds you want this feature to get activated. So currently I set it to be active in 4 seconds after the blinker stops blinking. However, you can do it even in 1 second if that's how you feel comfortable using it. Now, when this feature is not gonna work, first, it's not gonna work if you try to steer before you turn your turn signal. So let me show you. I'm doing the maneuver, then I turn on the turn signal, then I complete the maneuver, and the autopilot is not gonna engage for me automatically. So I need to reach back forward and do it myself. The second way this feature is not gonna work also is if you press the brake pedal when you're doing the lane change. So for example, if I turn on my turn signal, start doing the lane change, and then something happens in front of me and I press on the brake pedal to cancel the autopilot, this feature is canceled as well. So it's not gonna re-engage, so it doesn't shock you, because we do not know if you wanna continue using it or not. So you obviously need to reach back forward and activate yourself. And obviously there's a third way to cancel it, and that is if you do it manually by just pressing on the scroll wheel to deactivate the autopilot, or you use the stock if you're on the older models. Then this feature is not gonna re-engage for you also. One cool thing is that if you're doing your maneuver but something happens in front of you and you need more time to reactivate this feature, you can just press on the turn signal just to re-engage the timer once again, and then the countdown is gonna begin all over again. Let me show you how it works. So I'm gonna activate the autopilot, and let's say I wanna do a lane change. So I turn on my turn signal, I see there's a person behind me, I turn on my turn signal again, and I keep it constantly on until I'm comfortable doing the lane change. I switch the lane, but then I decide that I wanna go back to the other lane. So I turn on my turn signal once again. Let's say I wanna go to the right this time. I go to the right. Now I'm on the right lane, and then the autopilot is gonna re-engage when the timer goes off. Then I press the brake to cancel it, and then I can continue my journey and drive as I feel comfortable doing it. So yes, a few cue notes to remember. Again, do not use the short version of the turn signal, the 3-blinker one, because that's gonna cancel your blinker immediately when you disable your autopilot, which is not a good option for you to have, since you're not gonna have enough time to go to the lane next to you. That's why I always use the standard option for the turn signal, not the short one. And also make sure that you're activating the auto cancel feature inside your Tesla screen, because that way you don't have to reach back for the stock or for the button for the turn signal to do an extra movement. Give it a try, let us know how it works. A lot of people are already using it and they're super happy with it. So we are excited to hear your opinion underneath this video. See you soon.